As we all know, February is Black History Month. To learn more about the diversity that we have on campus, we have two representatives from Students United to Improve Race Relations, also known as SUTIRR. First, we have Amandine Lewis Charles, Student Government President. With us today is also Lizbeth Vasquez. She's involved in JROTC and UNIDOS Now. Thank you guys for being with us today.
Of course.
Now, Amandine, what does Black History Month mean to you?
As a person of color living in the United States, Black History Month to me is just a time to really celebrate and come up and just think back and reflect on our history as people of color, not only in the United States, but from a global aspect. It's a really important time for us to learn more about our history and just the inventors and all the great things that are not necessarily always in textbooks that we read about, because a lot of my history I had to research on my own. And I think it's a really important time to just educate our young girls and young boys about their history, and that it's not only slavery, it's not only the bad parts, but there are so many things that wouldn't be, the world wouldn't be the way it is today if it wasn't for so many Black inventors. So I think it's just a really important time to just reflect and just educate ourselves and others.
Yes, definitely, I fully agree. And now, Lizbeth, why should we celebrate Black History Month?
We should celebrate Black History Month because it's a time for us to remember all those struggles that African Americans went through to get to where we are today, to obtain the equality that we have today in the United States.
Yes. And Amandine, who is your favorite Black figure?
My favorite Black figure would have to be Michelle Obama. I absolutely adore her. She's just everything. She's been a role model to me since I was really young, because growing up, there wasn't a lot of female figures, especially Black in politics, that were taken seriously, and watching her sort of made me believe in myself, because I do want to be in international politics. It sort of made me believe in myself that if she could do it, I could do it too. And reading her recent memoir, Becoming, has absolutely changed my life, because it just gave me the confidence to achieve what I want to and not necessarily think about the societal boundaries of what a woman should be or how a Black woman should act. So Michelle Obama would definitely have to be my absolute favorite Black figure, because she's just been a role model to me my whole life. So
yes. And now, Lizbeth, are you or your family doing something special for Black History Month?
Unfortunately, we're not. Some other things came up which did not allow us to plan for this special occasion.
Mm-hmm. Well, of course, it's always a celebration.
Yes.
Throughout the month.
So. It's just not this month.
But yeah. Yeah, of course. And Amandine, now this is a more interesting question. Do you think that Southeast does enough to celebrate Black History Month here on campus?
I do think Southeast High School does showcase our diversity to a certain extent. However, there's always more that can be done to sort of embrace, because we do have a really large population of student of color. So I think there's definitely more things that we could do to implement Black History Month. But like, I know sometimes at lunch we're playing music by African-American artists and things like that, just sort of like to get in the mood to a certain extent. But I think there's definitely a lot more that can be done to showcase our diversity on campus.
Yeah, potentially beyond like media, right?
Yes.
And now, Lizbeth, how should students at Southeast celebrate Black History Month?
Well, I think that we should definitely talk about it more in the classrooms, and everybody should come up with their own ideas of how they want to, you know, showcase it. Maybe, you know, dress up as your favorite character, or watch a movie and reflect on how, you know, they impacted us. You know, there's different ways that we can celebrate this special month.
Yes, I fully agree. And now, Amandine, how does SUTIRR embrace our community's diversity here at Southeast?
I think SUTIRR sort of creates this space for literally anyone, no matter your racial background, not necessarily Black or white or Hispanic or anything, to just come in and just have these discussions about things that are happening around us. And I think it just creates this really safe space for people to sort of voice their opinions, how they feel about different things. And I also think it's really important that we do these projects where we go and read to middle elementary schoolers about their history, because a lot of these things are not necessarily thought on a broader scale, or it's just like passed on in classrooms. But just to have other people come in and read to them and talk to them about, this is, you know, you're more than just slavery, you're more than just emancipation. So I think it's just really important that I think SUTIRR definitely contributes to that.
Awesome. And now, Lizbeth, how would a student join SUTIRR?
Definitely visit SUTIRR.org to learn more about our mission, and speak to Ms. Coronado in room 917.
Awesome. Well, fantastic. Thank you guys for coming so much, and thank you for dedicating your time to this cause.
My pleasure.
No problem.
De nada.
And as one final note, Happy National Harriet Tubman Day.